Hello everyone and welcome back to Eve Market, your weekly look at the Amman market. For now, this is the second time I record this video because my other one, somehow my headset drivers managed to crash and had no audio or no sound at all recorded. I found out a little bit later. So the second time I recorded for my home system in this case. My home system is Ebo. I set my market up so I can see the prices in Amman easier. So we still have Amman prices in Amman only from a different station. So we're gonna start straight off with titanium. Oh yeah, another thing, I don't have the price from last week anymore because already changed. So you have to do with this week's. So titanium, it's going a little bit up on its price. 5 days, 20 days, not doing anything yet. It looks like just last few days it's a little bit going up on this price. It's not a lot. Prices for titanium for the sellers in Amman. 4.75. On the sellers, on the buyers in 4.68. I do remember this one. This was exactly the same price as last week. So there was no change to this. I do not remember the rest of the minerals. I don't know this one. So this one is exactly the same as last week. So next up, ferrite. Ferrite is going up, at least for today. It has had a little bit more spikes. A spike earlier this week. Then it dropped back to its old price a bit. But now definitely the higher spike than the other two. So ferrite, possible going up on its price. At least 5 day and 20 day are going up on its price. For the prices, for the sellers in Amman, 11.77. On the buyers, we're sitting at 11.63. Little bit of a change. It looks like definitely it's going up on its price on ferrite. Next up is Maxelon. We know it was going up and it's still going up on a steady line. Little bit of a higher point here today. So maybe giving a little bit of extra push up on this price. But 5 day and 20 day both are still going up for the prices. On the seller's price in Amman, we're sitting at 42 is flat for Maxelon. On the buyer's price, sitting at 41.17. Also pretty, you see there are pretty big orders up for Maxelon. So I definitely say this is gonna go up. Next one is Isogen. This is, there's nothing happening here still. It looks like it's going a little bit up on its price. Not a hell of a lot. At least a 5 day, it went a little bit up for the last 3 days, but it's hardly anything. Prices for Isogen in Amman are 125.96 for the sellers, on the buyers in 120.65. And there are also pretty big orders for this, so it may gonna push a little bit more up. Cannot really tell because it's been flat for such a long time. Next up is Noxium. Noxium is going a little bit up on the 5 day. It's not a huge amount. It seems to be pretty much flat. Not doing a lot. Prices for Noxium, 657.99 for the sellers. On the buyers, it's in a 650.02. And that's a very small order, by the way. So next one, 650.01. That one is core as usual. I think, out of my head, Noxium went a little bit lower than last week. I'm not sure, but that are the price for Noxium at least. Then, next one is Zynrud. Zynrud, ooh, look at this. Looks like Zynrud definitely hit his bottom point. Because for the last 3 days, it's been sold for above 600. So it looks like Zyne finally hit his bottom point and is changing after 5 months of dropping in price. It's now definitely having going an uptrend in price. At least for the last 3 days, the price is higher above the 600. So the 5 days going up and the 20 days already starting to follow to going up. So it looks like the prices for Zyne with 629.99 for the sellers, on the buyers 598, just below the 600 still, which is not a lot. Then next one, Megasite. Megasite doesn't seem to do anything yet. It's still sitting around the 1600 mark, just a little bit above it. It's a little bit high point here today to push the 5 day a little bit up. 20 days not doing anything yet. It looks like it's flattening out the 20 day. So maybe it's getting a stable point or it's gonna go up. Not sure. Prices for Megasite: 1655 for the sellers, for the buyers at 1612. Not a big order, but still. And this one is above the 600. Next one is below the 600, so 1600. So, yeah. These are small orders. Probably nobody's gonna go above this unless they really want it. If there are gonna be more orders above this one, definitely gonna see a little bit more increase in price for Megasite. Last mineral is Morphite. It's regularly bouncing around at the same point. Yeah, what to tell about it. There's not a huge amount being sold here per day, about 200,000. So yeah, it's never had a very stable point. Prices, 7,616.5 for the sellers. On the buyers, it's 7,380. For the Morphite. Let's go on for a little bit of a salvage. Armor plates. Armor plates are going up. 5 days still going up steadily for the last 2 weeks. 20 day is starting to follow now too on the uptrend for the prices. Seller's price 175,744. On the buyers, we're seeing 153,000. Yeah, 14-ish cents, that's not really a lot. So, burn logic circuits. Still going very aggressively up on price. One yesterday and the day before that, it was even above the 35,000-ish mark. Now it's below it again. 5 and 20D both going up on its price. Prices for the sellers, decent amount, is about 35,000. And for the buyers, we're sitting at 33,500, just a little bit above it. Next one is Fried Interface Circuits. It went up last week. We made the video, now after that it went down again. It's still going a little bit up on this price. 5 and 20 days both still going a little bit up for the last 3 days. So it's still moving on. And yeah, it doesn't look really they found ever a good spot. Seller's price just above the 4,500 for the Fried Interface Circuits. On the buyers, we're sitting at 4,258 on the buyers price. Melted Capacitor Consoles. They have been very flat on the 6,000 for a few days, like 5 days. But today we have definitely a higher point here on it. It's sitting around 6,300, it looks like. So someone is definitely buying a lot. Or fulfilling, or probably buying straight off the market a lot, which is pushing this one up. 5 days going up, 20 day is not doing really anything yet. 20 days more like flat on this line. Let's look at the prices. For the sellers, we're sitting just below the 7,000 on this prices. On the buyers, we're sitting at 6,000. And then not really a huge amount of orders up here in this melted capacitor consoles. Let's go on for the last one. Twip power circuits. Wow. I don't know what happened here. It just has a drop for like 7 to 8,000 drop in price in one day. That's a hell of a lot. A hell of a big drop. Don't know what is happening here, but 5 days dropping. It was already dropping for a while, for like 1.5 months. So 5 and 20 days, but today is just a huge drop. It has the trip power circuits. Prices for trip power circuits for the sellers 105,000 flat. For the buyers, I think 100,000. It's definitely a huge drop, about 7 or 8,000 drop in price suddenly. Don't know what is causing that. Someone dropping his whole load suddenly on the market, selling it straight to the buyers. That's what I probably think. What has happened. So this was this weekly look at the prices in Amar. A little bit of a different way because my first video minute had no sound at all. The whole video was broken even. I could not even play it. So something crashed on drivers when I was recording it. So I will see you guys all next week when we will be from Amar again. And we will be then just before Rubicon is coming out. That one is coming out on the 19th this month. So then just a few 2 days before EVE Online Rubicon is coming out. So we'll see, we have some new stuff coming to the market that we're gonna follow then. And we'll see what's gonna happen with those. So we'll see you all next week and fly safe.